In the figure, you have a circle with center at O. Let me mark two points on the circle, A and B. These two points divide the circle into two parts or two arcs. The lower arc in red color and the upper arc in blue color. I'm going to mark two more points on the circle. C is a point on the blue arc and D is a point on the red arc. Now we can call the red arc as arc ADB and the blue arc as arc ACB. Here arc ADB and ACB combined to form a full circle. Here we can call arc ACB as the alternate arc or the complementary arc of ADB. Conversely, ADB is the alternate arc of ACB. Consider the arc ADB. I am going to join the ends of the arc A and B to the center O to form an angle at the center. And this angle at the center, angle AOB, is called the central angle of the arc ADB. Now let me join the ends A and B to a point C on the alternate arc of ADB. An angle is formed at a point on the alternate arc, angle ACB. Here the arc ADB making two angles, one at the center and the other at a point on its alternate arc. Let me measure the central angle of the arc ADB, that is 130 degrees. I'm going to measure the angle on the alternate arc, it is 65 degrees. So you can see the angle on the alternate arc is half of the central angle. Now if I move the point on the arc, alternate arc, you can see it is always half of the central angle. Let me move the point B to change the central angle to 120 degrees. Then you can see the angle on the alternate arc is half of the central angle. Again I am changing it to 100 degrees. You can see the angle on the alternate arc is half of the central angle. Now consider the arc ACB, which is in blue color. What is the central angle of that arc? It is on the upper part. Let me measure the central angle of ACB, and that is 230 degrees here. Now I am going to join the ends of the arc ACB to the point D on its alternate arc AD and BD, making an angle at the point D, angle ADB. That is the angle made by the arc ACB at a point on its alternate arc. Let me measure that angle. That is 115 degrees. The angle made by the arc ACB at a point on its alternate arc is 115 degrees, and the central angle of the arc ACB is 230 degrees. You can see the angle on the alternate arc is half of the central angle. Now let me change the central angle of the arc ACB to 220, then you can see the angle on the alternate arc is half of it. So if I move the point D on the alternate arc, you can see always that is half of the central angle. Here in the figure, ACB and ADB form a pair of alternate arcs. And you have the central angles of both the arcs. And also, angle C is the angle made by ADB on its alternate arc. And angle D is the angle made by arc ACB on its alternate arc. Let the central angle of the arc ADB be D, then you know that the angle made by ADB on its alternate arc is D by 2. Now let the central angle of the arc ACB be C, then you have the angle ADB, which is the angle made by ACB on its alternate arc, C by 2. Now you can generalize the result like this. The angle made by any arc of a circle on the alternate arc is half the angle made at the center. Now, C and D are the measurements of the angles around the point O, which is the center. And you know that sum of the angles around a point is 360 degrees. Therefore, here in the figure, C plus D equal to 360 degrees. Here, angle ACB and angle ADB are angles on alternate arcs. Let me add those two angles, ADB and ACB. C by 2 plus D by 2. That is equal to C plus D whole divided by 2. But you have C plus D equal to 360. Therefore, this is 360 by 2. That is equal to 180 degree. So you have the sum of the angles ADB and ACB equal to 180 degrees. And these two angles are angles in a pair of alternate arcs. And the sum is 180 degree, means these two angles are supplementary. So we can say that the angles in alternate arcs are supplementary.